Welcome to Film Riot. As you may have noticed lately, we've been trying to connect with more filmmakers to bring their voices to you as well. I think it's important to hear a lot of perspectives and stories from several sources as you grow in your craft. And to that end, today we have a look at the coming short film, The Manual, by director Will Magnus. Will was kind enough to spend some time to give us a look into his path as a filmmaker and his process for making his latest and very ambitious short film. So now it's time for less talk from me and more insight from Will.
Hi, I'm Will Magnus, the writer and director of The Manual. About 10 years ago, I saved up and bought a Canon XL2 camera. It's one of those like really ergonomically designed cameras, sits right on your shoulder, shoots SD to mini DV, and I just started making films with friends and family. I didn't go to college or film school. Instead, I tried to learn the craft by watching online tutorials, reading books, and just making films. I made 5 short films over the course of 3 years, got pretty good at editing. I moved to Portland and started working professionally as a commercial editor, and then eventually as a commercial director. 2 years ago, I started seriously working on my film, The Manual, a half-hour post-apocalyptic film about the last human on Earth raised by a robot on a strange composite religion that's described in a handheld device called The Manual. I'm gonna share some of the tools that I used to communicate the vision to the crew, so that we end up with a cohesive story visually and narratively. The first thing is the script. It's important to know it backward and forward, to study it closely and know the world around it, the motivations of every character and the reason for every scene. All of the key crew should read it and understand it too. Set up some time to talk it through with them and hear their thoughts and ideas. When I took the time to go through this process, I found that aspects of the story that were clear in my head didn't actually make it into the script. And I was able to correct this and make the script much easier to understand. It seems obvious now, but getting a bunch of opinions on your script can produce a bunch of very interesting ideas. One example for our film is that the DP, Kevin Fletcher, suggested that our main character take on some of the speech patterns of the robot. Things like less contractions or more formal wordings or just more mechanical speech. This was a small detail, but it was awesome because it really reinforced the idea that this robot was the only thing that this child had experienced growing up. After the script, there's the shot list. I like to do this by myself, one scene at a time. I read through the scene, then close my eyes and watch the edit play out and take note of all the shots that I need to get that edit. Because my background professionally is in post-production, I've had to discipline myself into getting coverage beyond the edit I have in my mind. For The Manual, I assigned all the essential shots to the A camera and any extra coverage to the B camera. Also, because our B camera operator, Liam Gillies, is a skilled DP in his own right, I encouraged him to act as a sort of second unit DP and find his own compositions when he had gotten what I wanted. That ended up working out really well and gave us a lot to choose from in post. We created about 4 mood boards for The Manual. First, a look board where we figured out the visual style.
It's not about finding a film to model your film after. We pulled from photography, movies, all kinds of places. And the point is to find the details that you like in each of these images that will add up to creating your own unique look. We also did similar mood boards for wardrobe, for production design, for locations, just to have something visual that you can grab onto.
I like to storyboard every single shot. The point is to get the basic relationship of camera, subject, and environment into a frame so that you can clearly communicate how you're seeing the shot in your head. It doesn't mean it's necessarily going to be shot that way, but most of the time it is. These storyboards also come in extremely handy when you're putting your schedule together. It's very helpful to be able to glance at your schedule and see exactly what shots you're shooting. I'm not much of a drawer, but I feel like I'm good enough to do this myself and I'm able to save some money. As an independent filmmaker, that's important. Finally, it's good to get creative and make something that's unique and specific to your project to draw people into your world.
One example is I wrote 15 pages of the manual's sacred text. It gave my actors something to hold on to, something to ground them in this world that we were creating. I also gave it to key crew members, and it helped ground them in the world as well and understand a bit better what they were going for. Anything you can do to help draw your cast and your crew into the world you're creating can only make your movie better.
You never know where it'll lead. For the sacred text that I wrote, it ended up being a major aspect of the final film and added a lot of depth to the story. I learned two big things from making this film. The first is to always be open to new ideas and collaborations, taking criticisms and finding places to fit these into your story. Obviously, you need to be the one who's the gatekeeper of your story, so you can tell when an idea fits or when it doesn't. One example of this, I sent a rough cut of the film to my friend and fellow filmmaker, David Neum, and his biggest comment was that he could see that there was a person in the suit and it wasn't a real robot. I had been focused on wanting to have minimal CGI in the film and capture as much as possible in camera. So we had purchased these awesome solid blue contact lenses, but you could tell that it was a human. And I was able to correct this and replace her irises with CGI irises that I tracked onto the real ones. Because of my background in post-production, my post-production plan essentially consisted of I will just do it all by myself. That ended up being really hard on me personally and my family. So I think next time I will focus on putting in a real post-production plan, hiring an editor, hiring compositors. Filmmaking at its core is such a collaborative art form, and I've learned that if you know your story well, you can embrace that collaboration at every step of your production and come out with a film that's better than you imagined. Thank you so much for having me be a part of this show. If you'd like more information on the manual, you can visit our website at themanualfilm.com.
If you're a budding filmmaker, entrepreneur, or innovator, domain.com is the place to go when that next idea hits you. When you buy a domain name from domain.com, you are taking the first steps in creating an identity and vision for your brand or idea. The world's top two premier and most recognized domain name extensions are .com and .net, which means those are the ones that are going to help you build your brand and expand your presence online the best. And as always, by using the coupon code FILMRIOT at checkout, you're getting 25% off your order when you get domain names, web hosting, and email. And when you think domain names, think domain.com.
Logo.
And that's it for today. Thanks to Will for putting that together for us all. A short film comes out soon, but make sure you check linked in the notes below for the website for his short film and other social media links for him. And we're also working on a new project of our own that we're going to be releasing very soon. But we'll get more into that later, and I'll see you next week when the company lied and said that they couldn't save us because of a hurricane.